Hi everybody, this is Andrea Lee, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I do my makeup for a Sunday brunch. If you would like to see how I've created this look, then please keep on watching. I really need to hurry because in just 1 hour, I will have brunch with our friend, Clément. So the first thing I'm gonna use is this primer, Becca Backlight Priming Filter. It is a illuminating primer. I really, really like this one. I don't know if you can see it on the camera, it illuminates the skin really well. I'm gonna be using the new foundation from Giorgio Armani, it's Power Fabric. This is a very light color for me, it's 4.5 because I've got a little bit of self-tan. So I'm going to mix it with a little bit of Luminous Silk foundation, number 7.5. The Power Fabric foundation has much more coverage than the Luminous Silk one. Taking my beauty blender. This seems like a right color. As I said, I'm going to have brunch, so I'm going to have people sitting very, very close to me. I do not want to wear a foundation that is really thick, but I do want some coverage. So if you're looking for that really nice finish that doesn't look like a mask, I really recommend this one from Giorgio Armani, the Power Fabric. Next, I'm going to be using a concealer from Maybelline. It's the famous Fit Me concealer. This one reminds me of NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. So I'm gonna use it under my eyes, on my chin, on my forehead a little bit, and just a tiny little bit on my nose. These are the areas that I would like to brighten up a little bit. Taking my beauty blender. Ah, this is perfect. It has a really, really good coverage. I apply the concealer on my eyelids as well as a base. If you have oily eyelids, I recommend you to use a base like Soft Ochre Paint Pot from MAC or the Urban Decay one. NARS also have a really, really good eyeshadow primer. I'm almost at the end with my translucent loose setting powder from Laura Mercier, but I have a new one right here. What did you think? That I'm unprepared? Who do you think I am? I'm making sure that my product didn't crease. And then I'm taking a little bit of powder, and I'm not gonna bake, you know, I'm not gonna put the powder on my face and let it sit. I'm just gonna press the powder into my skin. I start with the under eye area. And I go on with the rest of the face using the same technique. I do this because I want my foundation and basically everything I'm using to be set all day long because I do not have the time to, you know, retouch my makeup. This is a great tip if you have oily skin. I'm gonna put a little bit of powder on my eyelids as well. Next, I'm gonna contour my face and I'm gonna be using this product from Marc Jacobs. This is really, really practical, this big mirror. I start from the line of my hair. I go right under my cheekbone because I wanna lift my cheekbones, okay? If you do a line till the corner of your mouth, cheeks are gonna actually drop. I'm using this Hakuhodo brush, J5521. I'm just blending the edges right now. I do contour my forehead, even though I don't need it that much. But I want my makeup to look natural. Next, I'm gonna be using this Hoola bronzer. And I'm gonna be using a Anastasia Beverly Hills A20 brush. I just wanna give a little bit of warmth. So I place this on top of my contour. Next, I'm gonna be using this Dip Brow Pomade from Anastasia Beverly Hills in medium brown. I'm taking an angled brush. This is 7B from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I take just a little bit of product and I fill my eyebrows wherever it needs a little bit of filling. Clear Brow Gel from Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is going to hold the hair in place. Give it a really nice, clean look. I love this product. For my eyes, I'm gonna be using this palette from Tarte Cosmetics, Tartelette, and it looks like this. I'm just gonna play with Wanderer, it's right here, and Dreamer. Yes, Dreamer, it's right here. MAC 217 brush, first color Wanderer. Just gonna place it in my crease. Really fast, I only have like 20 minutes left. I'm gonna put the same color on the corner of my eye and on my lower lash line, same brush. No time to switch. You know what? I forgot how good and blendable these colors are. Amazing. With the 221 brush from MAC, I'm gonna take the darker color, the Dreamer, and I'm just gonna place it right here in the corner. And in the crease, but just a tiny little bit. I don't want anything too much. Taking a clean blending brush, like I have this A10 from Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I'm just going to blend everything. Next, I'm gonna be using this new eyeshadow stick from Marc Jacobs. It looks like this. I'm going to place this all over my eyelids. This eyeshadow does not move, doesn't creases, for me at least. It's really, really good. Next, I'm gonna be using mascara from Clinique, High Impact Mascara. This is just a sample. This is by far my favorite mascara. You see, one coat. This is how my eyelashes look. With two coats of mascara. Now I'm gonna use it on my lower lashes as well. I do zigzag moves. For my lips, I'm using this lip liner from MAC, color Subculture. Then I'm gonna use this beautiful color lipstick from NARS and I'm gonna apply it straight from the bullet. I don't want too much color, so that's why I'm using my fingers to sort of blend the color. It's like a really nice pinky, peachy lipstick color. I love it. Then I'm gonna use a blush from Becca. This is Snapdragon, and the color looks like this. I'm taking a 114 brush from Zoeva. Oh my god, I think this is my new favorite blush. This is so pretty. Becca, you did such a great job. By the way, we will have Becca in the stores starting with May here in France, so I'm very excited about that. I have another great product from Becca, and this is the Moonstone highlighter. It is so pretty, but I'm not sure the cam could catch how pretty this is. I'll take a fan brush, and this one is from Zoeva, 129 brush. Oh my god, Becca. This is so pretty. I don't want anything that you could see from the space. I add a little bit on the tip of my nose. And on the bridge of my nose as well. I'm using Fix Plus from MAC to melt all the powders that I've put on. This is a really, really good tip. If you have been using a lot of product on your face, you could spray this product and your skin is gonna look like skin, you know? Okay guys, so this is the look for the Sunday brunch. I hope you enjoyed it. If you guys liked it, don't forget to give me a thumbs up and show me some love on Instagram, Snapchat, and Facebook. If you're not subscribed to my channel, please do that and you'll be notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye.
It's all you and me.